Hi, I'm Georgia, fashion eyewear specialist here at ReadingGlasses.com. Today is a special treat for me. I get to present a class of products that makes us especially proud to showcase. Products made right here in the good old US of A. Buy American is a nice slogan, but it's more than a mere sentiment. It's an acknowledgement that craftsmanship is alive and well in this country. To prove the point, we'll be looking at a Made in America collection with a rich history. Here is a collection from Shuron, based in Greenville, South Carolina. The Shuron collection of frames has been around for more than 140 years. Do the math. That's when the flag just had 38 stars and before there was even Coca-Cola. The name might sound a little foreign, but it is 100% American. The pince-nez, most notably associated with President Teddy Roosevelt, were popular glasses of the day. A common problem with them was that they would often fall off the bridge of the nose. That's until an enterprising company came up with a design to alleviate that problem. Naturally, they wanted the name to communicate the benefit, so they came up with Shuron, as in the glasses would stay sure on your nose. Shuron's current look is more 50s, 60s retro, but they are still 100% made in America. In fact, Shuron has never stopped manufacturing these same frames since the 50s and 60s, and they pride themselves in maintaining the level of quality and craftsmanship that created their original success. Now, let's take a look at some of the models. This is the Ronseer. If you've ever watched movies set in the 50s and 60s, JFK, LA Confidential, Malcolm X, and so many more, you've no doubt seen these beauties in action. Part of their charm lies in the proportions of the design itself and the interesting marriage of materials. Now, the best part is how they flatter the wearer while exuding a definite, no, I did not get dressed to impress you air. Ronseer is available in the original period colors and a variety of sizes, narrow, average, and wide, guaranteeing you'll find a perfect fit. One of our customer reviews of Ronseer described them as the most perfect glasses for a human. As you might expect, Ronseer comes in lots of lens choices, from clear single vision to no-line progressive to reading sunglasses. This is the Ronseer Revelation, a slightly smaller, feminized version of the classic Ronseer. Like its big brother, the Revelation is an example of what is called brow line glasses. Now, the term comes from how the frame follows the curves that you see when you focus on a person's eyebrows. The style's popularity has made a comeback in recent years with a rising interest in retro style. Here we have the Freeway. The Freeway is an unapologetic hunk of translucent plastic fashioned into a work of art. The bold, chunky, super durable frame evokes images of Hollywood's leading men, both on and off screen. Freeway presents a timeless look with a fit and finish that has to be held and petted to be fully appreciated. ReadingGlasses.com offers Freeway in a full range of sizes, narrow, regular, average, and extra wide. And we carry them in the original colors, from Cary Grant Black to translucent crystal. Naturally, you can equip your Freeway with lenses of your choice. Clear single vision, no line progressives, reading sunglasses, you name it. All of Shuron's quality frames are made right here in the US. That's rare these days, which makes it that much more wonderful. Okay, that wraps up this warms my heart presentation of ReadingGlasses.com Made in America. It's so great to see that Shuron is carrying on the tradition of quality American manufacturing with the finest materials and handcrafting them with the greatest care and pride. And that makes us proud to be entrusted to deliver such products to you. Finally, please remember that we take as much pride in delivering delightful customer service as Shuron takes in making such incredible products. We are intent on you having a wonderful shopping experience, period. And our no-risk, free shipping and returns policy is just the very tip of the iceberg. One in Alaska, USA, of course. Until next time, let me just say, God bless the good old US of A.